Hey, what's up everyone? It's Eric here from Guy and Kicks, bringing you another review. And it's that time of year where I get to review an Air Jordan 11 and why it might be the most important Air Jordan. Let's jump into it. Today's video is on the Air Jordan 11 Jubilee. Alright guys, so I'm sure most of you already know this, but for those that may not know, the Air Jordan 11 released in 1995. It was for the 95-96 season. When that shoe originally released, it released for $125, and it was designed by Tinker Hatfield. Tinker basically wanted to create a very luxurious sneaker, obviously a shoe that would stand out. So a lot of its inspiration actually came from a tuxedo, obviously the patent leather being the main part of a tuxedo outfit that stands out here with the Retro 11. But is this the most important Jordan ever? I mean, that's up for debate. Obviously, you have the Retro 1 that every time it releases, it just sells out and is so popular. So that's up for debate. But when this shoe does come out, you know, especially now we're used to seeing a Retro 11 every year, always around this time of year, around Christmas time. And you know, when it does come out, you know, most people go for it. It sells out immediately because there's a lot of nostalgia behind this shoe, especially if you grew up watching Jordan. It's actually the Jordan that stands out the most out of all the Jordans. And there's been some weird designs that you kind of scratch your head of who designed that shoe. But this one, man, over time, it just keeps getting better and better. And it still looks very clean and actually looks very modern today. And for Jordan, I believe this is his favorite Jordan ever, and for good reason. I mean, the 1995-96 season, the Bulls went 72-10. Jordan won the MVP, he won the All-Star MVP, won the Finals MVP, and basically the dude just killed it that year. So I do understand why the Retro 11 means so much to him. But jumping into the Jubilee here, the name basically comes from, you know, celebrating a special anniversary, like a 25-year or 50-year anniversary. So this year is the 25th year of the Retro 11, so that's why they decided to go with the Jubilee name. The shoe released on December 12, 2020 for a retail price of $220. I mean, we've all seen the Retro 11, so we know basically what the materials consist of. If you've been a fan of Michael Jordan, been a fan of basketball, or just been a fan of sneakers, I'm pretty sure you've already seen the Retro 11 many, many, many times. So we don't really have to go super deep into the materials here because it's pretty much the same thing. But in this Jubilee, there are some material changes, some design changes that I appreciate very much. Here on the upper, you have that Cordura nylon material that's supposed to make the shoe a little bit lighter. Unlike other Retro 11s, here on this one, on the eye stays, you have the Jordan name spelled out on both sides, on the lateral and medial side. Here in the middle of the tongue, you have the Jordan brand. As you come down to the toe box and throughout the mid part of the shoe, wrapping around the shoe, is where you're gonna find the patent leather material. Moving to the heel part of the shoe, you're gonna find the Jumpman logo with the 23 there as well. I do like this material. It does give it a premium look to it. I don't think it's metal or anything like that, even though when you initially do touch it, it does feel cold. I just think that it's probably like a fancy plastic material and it's covered with a metallic material, but it does look nice. It does give the shoe a nice luxurious look to it for sure. You have here the all white midsole and you have the outsole wrapping around the midsole here. Moving over to the outsole here, you're gonna find the shank plate that it's made out of the carbon fiber material, which is very cool. I mean, the Retro 11 was the first one to have the patent leather material and also the first one to have a carbon fiber plate in the outsole of the shoe for stability and support. Obviously, the carbon fiber just makes a lot of sense. It's a lighter material, but it's also very strong and very durable. So with the patent leather, you're adding more weight to the shoe. So combining the carbon fiber and the nylon material here, it does take some of the weight off this shoe. Another cool detail about this outsole is that I actually found this out today myself, is that, yeah, you know, we're accustomed to seeing the outsole in this clear material, obviously with the Concord, you know, we're all used to calling it the icy bottoms, but that actually has a purpose. Not only is it for you to see the inside of the outsole of the shoe, almost like showing off a nice luxurious car or something like that, but supposedly the clear outsole provides additional grip to the outsole. So That actually makes a lot of sense, and I didn't even know that. And when I found that out today, I was like, it's pretty interesting. And finally, you do see the Jumpman logo on top of that carbon fiber plate. So yeah, guys, so the Retro 11 for me and for most of you guys, I'm sure, is a classic. Not only is the Retro 11 still very relevant here in 2020, the shoe still looks modern. It doesn't even feel like the shoe. It's been around for 25 years, which is amazing. You know, some of Jordan's classics, like the ones, the threes, the fours, the fives, for example, you see, you know, you look at those shoes and they do look very, you know, 90s or 80s inspired, right? But this one, even though it's from 1995, it doesn't really look like it's a 90s shoe. I mean, of course, it's bulky and it's big, but it still looks very modern. You see a lot of NBA players still wearing this shoe. And it's definitely because of the technology that was used, the materials that are used, that are still very, very relevant today. NBA players are playing in them. It's obviously still very comfortable and great to play in, right? So yeah, so in terms of this being the most important Jordan ever, I mean, yeah, you know, it's subjective. I mean, it just depends on, you know, what you think of other Jordans, especially the ones, because that's the main sneaker that obviously just keeps selling out over and over. And with all the dope collaboration that's been going on in the last few years, I mean, it's very hard to argue which one's better between the 1 and the 11. But if the conversation is in terms of the materials, in terms of how it's still relevant today, I mean, I guess you do have to give it to the 11, you know, because it's still being used today by many basketball players from junior high school to the pros. So it is still being used today, where, you know, the Retro 1 is just a lifestyle shoe, period. Where this one, it is still relevant and it is still being used. So I guess you can make the argument in terms of that. Obviously, if you want to talk about sales and which one's more popular, for sure the Retro 1 is still, you know, very, very popular. The 11 can't compete with that. But overall, I think this is a very clean shoe. I think this colorway is super clean because, you know, with the basic white and black and, you know, silver accents here, you know, it makes the shoe a lot more wearable. My favorite 11 is the bread. And sometimes, you know, it's a little bit harder to just throw on an outfit with black and red. But with this one, it's just a lot easier. It's super clean, white and black. I do love that the outsole is not in that icy bottom material. I like it that it has sort of like that milky look to it. So hopefully that will protect the outsole a little bit more and it won't turn as yellow as they normally do. Looking at some of the resale prices, I mean, right now is not too insane. So if you do want to get one, probably now is the best time. I think last year with the Brez, it was the same thing. Sort of stayed in that 260, 280 range. And now a year later, obviously the prices have gone up. So if you want to get them, probably get them now or wait. There might be some restocks going on in the next week or so. If I were you, I'd definitely keep an eye on that. Also, guys, the shoes come in this box. I'm glad they went back to you know, giving us a nice fancy box. Last year with the Brez, it just gave us a regular box. I wasn't too happy about that. But this year, they, you know, for the 25th anniversary, they went a little bit all out here. So I'm glad they did that. Here's the official tag. And that's it. Let me show you how they look on feet. All right, guys, so I hope this video showed you a detailed look of the Air Jordan 11 Jubilee. Christmas is around the corner, so I hope all of you have a very happy holiday. Like always, I just want to thank you for watching my video. I appreciate that very much. If you haven't yet subscribed, please feel free to hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button if you liked the video. Follow me on Instagram at Guy and Kicks, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. See ya.